Blessed be the one holy and living God.
Glory to God forever and ever.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For our song of praise, you can open your hymnals to hymn 376, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore You.
Israel. Could I not wash in them and be clean? He turned and went away and servants approached, said to him, Father, if the prophet had commanded you to do something difficult, would you not have done it? How much more when all they said to you was, wash and be clean? So he went down and immersed himself 7 times in the Jordan according to the word of the man of God. His flesh was restored like the flesh of a young boy, and he was clean. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit, the Lord of the Spirit. So that Gospel of our Savior Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
The Lord appointed 70 others and sent them on ahead of him in pairs to every town and place where he himself intended to go. He said to them, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. Go on your way. See, I am sending you out like lambs into the midst of wolves. Carry no purse, no bag, no sandals, and greet no one on the road. Whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this house.' And if anyone is there who shares in peace, your peace will rest on that person. But if not, it will return to you. Remain in the same house, eating and drinking whatever they provide, for the laborers deserve to be paid. Do not move about from house to house. Whenever you enter a town and its people welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick who are there, and say to them, 'The kingdom of God has come near to you.' But whenever you enter a town and they do not welcome you, go out into its streets and say, 'Even the dust of your town that clings to our feet, we wipe off in protest against you. Yet know this, the kingdom of God has come near. Whoever listens to you listens to me, and whoever rejects you rejects me, and whoever rejects me rejects the one who sent me.' The 70 returned rejoicing, 'Lord, in your name even the demons submitted to us.' He said to them, 'I watched Satan fall from heaven like a flashing of lightning. See, I have given you authority to tread on snakes and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing will hurt you. Nonetheless, do not rejoice at this, that the heavens submit to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven.'" The Gospel of the Savior.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Backwater country he has recently defeated in battle.
Naaman's chariot load of riches, the king of Israel doesn't receive him. Instead, he gets shuttled off to see some unknown prophet, and the prophet won't even bother to come out and meet with him. Elisha sends out one of his servants, tells the great general to wash in the muddy waters of a second-class river. Oh, how I can feel Naaman's desperate indignation. It's like seeking help from a renowned specialist, yet only being seen by the nurse practitioner. Then she ignores your brilliant internet research and tells you to take a few Tylenol and rest for a week. Of course, the lesson here for us privileged warriors, God doesn't need our wealth, our power, or our knowledge in order to heal us. God can work through slave girls, obscure prophets, and muddy little rivers. God can work through poor unwed Mary, shepherds, and babies born in stables. God can work through ordinary bread, wine, and a broken body. We need only to grab the hands of the people God sends us, no matter who they are. We need only to lower the barriers that we hide behind and allow ourselves to feel vulnerable. It's a lesson that Jesus wants to teach us too in today's gospel reading. Jesus strips his followers bare of all illusions of control. He sends them out on his mission of healing. With only the support of a travel companion, each Jesus follower must head out barefoot and penniless. They must go out into a world that won't necessarily welcome them or their message. Surrounded by hostility, they're completely dependent upon the hospitality of those who welcome them. Can't demand or expect success. If they accomplish amazing things, they're not to take the credit. There's no promise of glory, no promise of nice church buildings, or a pension fund, or pews full of families with young children, or accolades from the neighborhood. There's merely the command to show up, and to heal the sick and broken. In Jesus' name. I still remember having disdainful thoughts on the first day of political pastoral education in seminary. The hospital chaplain was lecturing us on the importance of simply showing up in a crisis. We didn't need the answers, he said. We just needed to be present. What? I thought. How dumb. Just stand there while people are suffering. What good does that do? That's way too simple. Who wants to see a strange pastor type that they don't even know lurking around in times of grief? As I found out, that's exactly what people want. Loving presence. Standing with. Nadia Boltz-Weber says it best. Of course, just showing up is not as sexy as yoga, or praying the daily office, or doing the master cleanse, or a 10-day silent retreat. But showing up means being vulnerable in that empty-handed, set out by Jesus without sandals sort of way. It's the vulnerability of having nothing to offer but what we have been given by Christ. The vulnerability of receiving hospitality. The vulnerability of having difficult truths spoken to you. The lessons of today's readings spoke to my heart more than most. So much so that I really didn't want to have to preach on them. Like many of you, I imagine, I've been feeling wrong, angry, and helpless following the tsunami of Supreme Court rulings that just keep on coming. It's felt like getting hit every day with a 2x4 of dread. My beloved privilege feels like it's slipping My certainty that everything will work out in the end is deeply shaken. I feel as if I need to do something as an American, as a woman, and certainly as a priest. I want to be healed of our collective leprosy. I want to fix things for our country. I want to fix things for those who are truly suffering. I want to fix things for the Christians who just want to share the good news of love and healing. I want to lift the pain from your faces. But everything that I can come up with sounds too weak and common, like trying to cure a deadly disease by bathing in a foreign stream. We give prayer. The thoughts and prayers. Those who utter pious statements but refuse to act when children are being shot at school have tainted our common resource to prayer. I posted prayers last week on YouTube in an attempt to comfort some of us after the overturning of Roe v. Wade. They were great prayers, I thought, fitting prayers composed by a long list of Episcopal leaders from around the country. I felt good praying them online, until a YouTube viewer commented that my prayers were of no help to her whatsoever. She added that prayer would never help. And then several people agreed with her. A few days later, the court upheld the right of a football coach to pray a Christian prayer out loud with his public school team on the field. Oh, brother, I moaned. Is that how people saw my prayers, too? What, then, are we Christians supposed to do? What the Holy Spirit showed me in today's readings is that Jesus is asking us to show up vulnerable and open like sheep among wolves. Wolves of the Hebrew Scriptures are symbols for corrupt and greedy politicians and religious leaders who devour the poor and marginalized. Jesus' followers enter their presence unprotected, vulnerable, dependent only upon God and the hospitality of others. We don't need loud and public manifestations of faith. No hocus-pocus, no difficult feats to build up our own egos, no grabbing at the microphone at football games. We just eat with those in need of good news, live among them, stay with them, live regular lives together. Don't waste time in places we aren't wanted, and let God's healing happen through us. Not very flashy, but such is the kingdom of God. May we find, like Naaman, true healing there, in spite of ourselves.
Through him all things were made, for us and for ourselves.
is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people. I ask your prayers for God's people throughout the world. For our Bishop Kim and for the General Convention of the Episcopal Church, for this gathering, and for all ministers and people, pray for the church. I ask your prayers for peace, for goodwill among nations, and for the well-being of all people. Pray for justice and peace. Prayers for peace in Ukraine. I ask your prayers for the poor, the sick, the hungry, the oppressed, and those in prison. Pray for those in any need or trouble. Especially remember David, Bill, Jan, Jane. I ask your prayers for all who seek God or a deeper knowledge of God. Pray that they may find and be found by God. I ask your prayers for the departed, especially those we name now aloud in our hearts. For Joan,
Kathy,
pray for those who have died. Please add your own thanksgivings or intercessions, aloud or silently.
Give thanks for the healthy birth of your grandson, Sasha Paul.
The prayer to those in their forces in our country, the law officers of our land. Almighty God, we command your gracious care in keeping all the men and women of our armed forces, at home and abroad, the law officers across our land. We give them day by day with your heavenly grace, strengthen them in their trials and temptations. Give them courage, faith, and perils when confronting, and grant them a sense of your abiding presence forever and ever. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Praise God for those in every generation in whom Christ has been honored. Pray that we may have grace to glorify Christ in our own day.
And a prayer for our country on this July 4th weekend. Lord God Almighty, who have made all the peoples of the earth for your glory, to serve you in freedom and in peace. Give to the people of our country a zeal for justice and the strength of forbearance, that we may use our liberty in accordance with your gracious will. For Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Almighty God, by your Holy Spirit, you have made us one with your saints in heaven and on earth. Grant that in our earthly pilgrimage we may always be supported by this fellowship of love and prayer, and know ourselves to be surrounded by their witness to your power and mercy. We ask this for the sake of Jesus Christ, in whom all
us confess our sins to God. We confess that we have sinned against you, opposing the will of our lives. We have denied your goodness to each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that is within us, the evil we have done, and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your love and serve only your will.
God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Through Christ, let us continually offer to God the sacrifice of praise that is the fruit of lips that acknowledge God's name. Rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet, as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again, you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day, we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Glory and honor and praise to you, holy and living God, to deliver us from the power of sin and death, and to reveal the riches of your grace. Look with favor upon Mary, your willing servant, that she might conceive and bear a son, Jesus, the Holy Child of God. Living among us, Jesus loved us. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, healed the sick, and proclaimed good news to the poor. He yearned to draw all the world to himself, yet we were heedless of his call to walk in love. When the time came for him to complete upon the cross the sacrifice of his life and to be glorified by you. The night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with his friends. He took bread, gave thanks to you, broke it and gave it to them, and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again, he gave thanks to you, gave it to them, and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Now, gathered at your table, O God of all creation, and remembering Christ crucified and risen, who was and is to come, we offer to you our gifts of bread and wine, and ourselves a living sacrifice. Pour out your Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the body and blood of Christ. Breathe your Spirit over the whole earth, and make us your new creation, the body of Christ given for the world you have made. In the fullness of time, bring us with St. Ambrose and all your saints, from every tribe and language and people and nation, to feast at the banquet prepared from the foundation of the world. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory and praise forever and ever.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we share in the one bread. The gifts of God for the people of God. And for our friends on Zoom, let us pray the prayer of spiritual communion. Lord Jesus, as you promised to be with us in the bread and wine, that is your body and blood, grant that we may receive you spiritually today into our hearts, minds, and souls. Stay with us, be our companion in the way, kindle our hearts and awaken hope, that we may know you and have confidence in your loving care, now and forever. Amen.
through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Life is short, and we do not have too much time to gladden the hearts of those who walk the way with us. So be ready to love and unhesitating in kindness. And may the blessing of the deep mystery of God, source of life, love, and hope, Word of life, and ever-present Spirit of grace, be with you this day and all your days. Amen.